Okay, I'm going to show you a few embroidery stitches today. I'm just going to talk about a little bit about the thread. I don't usually do embroidery, so it might be I'm a bit rusty, but here we go. The first one I'm just going to show you is the chain stitch. For this one, I'm using the DMC, and I've used all six strands, so it means it's a bit thick and chunky, and it really depends on what look you want. So this is a chain stitch. So you're just going to put the thread the needle very close to your last stitch, and you're going to take it up whatever size stitch you want. I'm doing about 1/4 inch, and the thread just wraps around and you pull. With a thicker thread, you're going to actually have to tug a little bit and slowly pull through, and there's your chain stitch. Remember, you always need your line, which I actually don't have quite very clear, to see where you're going. So the needle goes very close, or in the same hole as the stitch before, about 1/4 inch on your line. Pull the needle through. Remember, it's a bit of a tug because it's a thicker thread. And there we go, there's your next chain stitch. Okay, so the next stitch I'm going to show you is called the stem stitch. I'm using the thick, the DMC again, just with the six strands, just to show you what it's like. Okay, for this one, what you're going to do is you put your needle in and you're going to bring it up where the last stitch finished. Oops, just take my hand to the back and pull it through. Again, it's a little bit of a tug because it's the whole six threads. Okay, that's your first stitch. Just gently pull. Again, you're going to go back, and where your last stitch finished, you're going to bring your needle up through the thread. Yep, there we go. Okay. Probably should have pulled my thread a little bit tighter there, but that's okay. Okay, back through where your last stitch finished, and there we go, and that's a stem stitch. Now, I've done a back stitch here, but just to show you the difference, I've only taken two threads from the embroidery floss, so it's going to be a bit easier, but obviously your stitching is going to be a bit finer. So the back stitch is simply go back to where the last stitch started, and you're going to go the same distance forward. I'm more or less doing 1/4 inch each time. Okay, it's a very, very simple stitch. Back to where the last stitch finished and forward. You can see it's much easier to pull through because you've only got two threads. Okay, now I'll show you this stitch, which is called a split stitch. Now, just to show you, I've actually done two rows of split stitched here, because that's one row and two, just to show you that you can actually, you don't have to do one line of stitching if you're doing the rainbow. You can do two or three lines of stitching just to make it much thicker. So this is a bit of a different stitch. So what you have to do is you actually have to take your needle to the back of your work, like that. Pull it through, and now you have to bring your needle up in between all the stitches, like you're splitting the stitches in half. Bit of a tug again because it's the six strands. Pull, take it to the back again. Some people like to use an embroidery hoop when they do their embroidery because it makes their work nice and firm, but I don't usually use an embroidery hoop. Okay, and you're going in between the stitches and pulling through. Okay, and there's, I just do one more split stitch, go to the back, bring the needle up through in the middle of all the stitches, and then you just keep on going. So as you can see, that's the second row. I started again, and there's the second row of stitches that I've done next to, just to show you what it looks like. Now for my next one, this is actually a really interesting stitch. It's actually a really great kids stitch. I've used for this one the Orifle thread. It's embroidery floss. It's a little bit thinner than the DMCs, and I quite like using it because it's much thinner. So This is what the finished stitch looks like, but how we begin is with a running stitch. So you just do the normal running stitch. You can do a couple of stitches in a row. You don't have to do just one. Although when I do start teaching kids, I only do one stitch at a time. Let's do a couple more. So you can go up, down. That's actually down, up. Down, up. Okay, this is how you start with a running stitch. I'll just do one more. Now this is the fun part, and kids love it. I get the back of the needle, and I'm going to just turn my work. I'm just going to go from right to left and pull. Of course, with embroidery stitches, you can really do whatever you want. So if you want to go from left to right, right, left, anywhere you want. Okay, I'm always just using the back of my needle and bringing it through. Now I'll just go up to here. Okay. And now I'm going to do exactly the same from the opposite direction, the left to right, left to right, with the back of the needle. Okay, and there's your stitch. If you want, you could go through the stitching again from the other direction. Really just depends whatever it is that you like. Okay, and there it is. So different stitches, you can really do whatever you want. You can make your stitches up, just see how you go. So there's our stitches, Orifil thread, DMCs. Let me know if you have any questions.